In today's tech video, we are going to do a couple reviews on this soundbar right here. This is the Samsung Q60. And then we're going to review this TV, which is a Samsung Q80, and how they work well together. So it's kind of a double review video, but that's what today's video is going to be about. Before we begin, do me a favor and hit that subscribe button and turn on your bell notifications so you can get notified for future videos. I'd love to have you back in the next one. Well, hey guys, Juan here. Thanks for stopping by my channel and checking out this video. So if you're watching this video, maybe you're in the market to buy this particular soundbar here, or maybe this TV here, or maybe one or the other, both of them, I don't know. But I have the Q80 QLED TV right here, which has been an awesome TV. I love this thing. And then I've got this new soundbar that I paired up with it, which is the Samsung Harman Kardon, which, just to give you a little bit of history there, Samsung bought out Harman Kardon. They wanted some of the patents that they had, so they just ended up buying the company outright, and so now they're together. So Samsung and Harman Kardon, both of their technologies combining to make this awesome soundbar here, which is the Samsung Q60. So I bought this thing. Now the TV on this, it has great sound already. You really don't even need a sound bar, but I got a pretty good deal and I wanted to have that nice booming, like movie theater effect of being in the movie theater, because going to the movie theater is pretty expensive anymore. So I got this soundbar to pair it up with this TV, and they match up really nicely together. So now this video is going to be structured a couple different ways. We're going to review this soundbar first, and then after that, we'll review the television after that. So if you're looking to just get the specifics on the TV, go ahead and fast forward to where I'm reviewing the TV. Now, if you're looking for the specifics on the review for the soundbar, then you can just stick around for that on the first portion. Or if you're looking for both reviews, just go ahead and watch the whole video, which I would really love if you did. So let's go ahead and dive into the review portion of the Q60 soundbar. Let's do that now. All right, so let's talk about the cosmetics on it first to get started off. So on the top and the side here, or on the front and the top here, it's got a metal grill that's kind of gives you a little bit of that industrial feel. And it is a pretty solid soundbar. It's got a little bit of weight to it. I did not mount it onto the wall. I just kind of put it right here. Well, basically, because I can't mount it onto the wall. I'm on a corner section here in this room, so there was no way for me to mount it. But if I did have that capability, I would probably mount it up higher just because I like that cleaner look. But I think it looks pretty good like this, just on the stand right below TV. And the way that Samsung designed this is to pair up with their television. So as you can see, it does not go up above the screen any. So that's kind of nice to give it that nice clean look. But it is a real sleek looking soundbar, and it's got the branding on the top here that says Samsung Harman Kardon, but it's black metal, real sleek looking. Now in the top corner over here, there's the indicator light. So whenever I press on the remote here, you'll see it comes up on the screen there, the volume, but it also comes up there on the indicator light. It says direct in, because I do have it hooked in with an optical cable. And then whenever I push up on it, there's a plus symbol. And then whenever you turn it down, there's a minus symbol. So the indicator light is only on this side of the soundbar, all the way to your right. And then also on this indicator light, it lets you know what input you are running. So since I am running an optical cable to it, it says direct in. If I was running Bluetooth, it would say BT. And if you're running like through an HDMI cable, it would say that also. Now the remotes on these things, they are really thin like that. So that makes it kind of easy to get lost in a couch or a chair, but they're really similar to the QLED TV remote. So let's take a good look at here. So this one here is the QLED remote. This one here is a soundbar remote. As you can see, there's not a whole lot of difference between the two. They're both real thin. They're angled like that, but yeah, they made them real similar to their QLED remote. Now, whenever you do hook in this soundbar, and if you are hooking it in to a Samsung TV, then you don't need the soundbar remote. You can control everything with a TV remote. So this is my TV remote, and it controls the soundbar volume and the TV shows you the indicator up there. So as soon as I did hook it in, it automatically recognized the sound bar. So the setup process on the sound bar was the easiest that I've ever experienced on hooking up any type of soundbar devices. As soon as I hooked it in, instantly recognized it. So there was no need of pushing a button and really pairing it to the TV. It works. Good job, Samsung. Now on the remote control for the soundbar, you can turn up the subwoofer sound and the regular sound volume. So it does give you two different options on there. It's got the option where you can display what kind of source you want on there, whether it be the Bluetooth or HDMI. And it's got the Bluetooth pairing button on there as well. Now the different sound types that this thing has, the different sound modes are standard, surround, Game Pro, and adaptive. Now the differences with these models is that surround gives you that all around widest sound stage, particularly in like a bigger section. So it gives you that nice all around sound. The Game Pro knows when you are gaming and it will adjust accordingly. So like maybe if you're playing some Call of Duty or something like that and there's loud guns, it will adjust the volume on the gun levels. So it's got that smart technology built inside of it that automatically detects that. And then last is the adaptive, and that will adjust on the fly based on the content that you are watching. So for example, if you're watching something that's real heavy in dialogue, it will adjust the voice accordingly to the show or the movie that you're watching, or maybe like the explosions. So it has that adaptive capability in there to control those different sound levels. Really cool technology. Now on the side of the soundbar over here on this side here, it does have a volume control button, a plus, a minus. It's got a button on there to push it for Bluetooth pairing. And what you would do with that, when you push the Bluetooth pairing, you gotta push it, it'll come up there, Bluetooth. Then you gotta hold the Bluetooth button for about 5 seconds, and then that sets it into pairing mode to pair it with whatever device that you're wanting to Bluetooth with it. So it is a little bit of a learning curve on that, but and it's really clean with not having a whole lot of buttons on the side there. And then of course there's the power button on the side as well. But when it comes to the Bluetooth, you might have to have a little bit of patience, 5 seconds. Okay, so now let me give you a little bit of a sound test with this to show you guys what it sounds like, and then I'll dive into more of the specifics with it. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is right now I've got a wireless Rode mic that I'm hooked up here. That's what's picking up my vocals. I'm going to take that microphone and try to give you guys the best sound test I can by putting the microphone right here near the sound bar. Now I'm going to play a non-copyright song here, Andrew Apple Pie. It's one of my favorites that I use for any type of vlogging or any kind of background music. But that's how I'll give you guys a sound test to kind of give you the best type I can for video. Okay, so here's a Rode mic. We'll go ahead and put that thing right here in the center. And let's go ahead and play it. Now what I'll do is I'll take the microphone and I'll stand back as far as where I would be sitting for movie watching, and to kind of give you guys what that sound would be like if you were sitting in that type of a distance watching a movie. So let's do that test now. Okay, so that gives you a little bit of an example of what this thing sounds like. It's a great sounding soundbar. So let's talk a little bit about more of the specifics here. So this soundbar will get you 360 watts of power coming out of these speakers. So there are speakers on the top, and then there are speakers here in the front that are booming out, and then you got the sound bar that I have sitting on the floor there. Now it is a 5.1 sound bar, which means that you do get a dedicated center channel, which does a fantastic job of handling the vocals when it comes to any kind of movies or anything like that. My wife and I were watching a television show the other day, and I was really surprised at how well it balanced the vocals with some of the like explosions or anything that were in the background. So that dedicated center channel does a fantastic job with that. Now with the rest of the speakers that go around the dedicated center channel, they do a fantastic job of filling in all those mids and giving you an example of what is all around there. So giving you that surround sound feel. Making this sound bar sound bigger than what it really is. Gives you that crisp sound, that big bass booming sound, and then it fills the room in really nicely. Now on the top of this sound bar, along the top right here, it's got that acoustic beam technology. Now what that is say there's like a, for example, there's a car, you're watching Fast or Furious or something like that, and there's something on the screen that moves here and just kind of moves along with the screen. The beam technology will give you that sound that kind of goes right along with it, just like that, moving with the action that's on the screen. Some really cool technology. Now I can't really show you on video, obviously, because it's video, but you're gonna have to take my word for it. That is a really nice little feature on this soundbar here. Now on the back of this soundbar, you do get some good connections, different types of connections to kind of go with whatever TV that you have. You get two HDMI imports. One of them is that ARC HDMI input. You get the regular 35 or 3.5 millimeter, the old fashioned stereo jack, you get that. And then you get the optical audio cable, which that's what I'm using here. And then if you wanted to, you could even Bluetooth it with the TV. But if you have this, I recommend that you go wired in. You're gonna get the best connectivity that way and you're probably your best sound. So I have it with the optical cable, but it does have that HDMI hookup also. Whatever type of TV that you're running to with this, it'll work. Now, the other great thing about this is it's not specific to the QLED. All right, if you had another Samsung TV, you could do that also. Or if you had another brand TV, Vizio, LG, or something like that, you could still use the soundbar with those models of televisions. But if you do purchase a QLED TV like I got here, I recommend that you complement it with one of these awesome soundbars. Just makes it a really cool movie experience, especially if you're spending that kind of money. Go ahead and just spend a few extra $100 and get this soundbar. And then you'll never have to go to the movie theater. You can just kind of stay home and watch your movies that way. But having those different hookups on the back of this thing make it very versatile to what you can hook this soundbar up to. Now, if this is the soundbar that you're gonna be adding to your entertainment system, comment down below, let me know. I'd like to hear if this is the one that you decide on or if you pick a different one, comment with that also. But yeah, this is the Samsung Harman Kardon Q60. Okay, now we're going to dive into the review portion of the Samsung Q80 television, QLED. So let's go ahead and put that footage in now. But as far as owning it for a few weeks now, it's been a great TV. The picture quality is awesome. I mean, like, really awesome. So I upgraded from a 4K UHD TV to this QLED 4K UHDV also. It's just bigger. I had a 55 inch and I went bigger to 65. So I think a lot of times whenever we upgrade our televisions, we usually end up going bigger. But that's what I did. And I gotta tell you, the picture on this, beautiful. It's just awesome. The other day I was watching Endgame on it and the clarity was so clear. It was almost like they were right there and I could reach in there and touch them. That's how the clarity is on this. So like right now, I've got a background image on here. This is kind of like their screensavers that they have. Samsung has built in a ton of different kinds of screensavers that you can put on there. So instead of just having like a black picture, whenever you're not watching TV, you can have something that's pretty to look at just like this, and it stays on there for quite a long time. Now, one of the main reasons that I went with the QLED when I was shopping around for televisions, because I had it boiled down to two TVs. I was either gonna get the Samsung QLED or I was gonna get the LG OLED display, because I think that's what TVs are gonna be going to in the future. So I wanted to make sure that I buy a TV that's gonna last a while and it's gonna be kind of future-proof. Because how often do you buy TVs for your main living room? Is, you know, every so many years. So I wanted to make sure that I got one that's gonna last a while and it's gonna be something that's gonna be you know, a good TV for years to come. But the reason that I went with this one, the QLED, was because when it comes to OLED and QLED, if you are in a room that has a lot of natural light, like for this room, for example, I've got a lot of windows over here, there's a couple windows over here, there's a glare that'll be on the TV. The Samsung QLED is better when it comes to glares on a TV than they are with OLED. So that was one of the big reasons that I went with this TV. Also, I am a fan of Samsung. I've had a few TVs of theirs and they've always lasted a long time versus somebody who maybe had a Vizio or something like that. I had a buddy who had a Vizio and it lasted like a year and it broke on him. My Samsungs have always lasted quite a long time. So they're a trusted brand. They're at the top, you know, they're right there with Sony and LG. And so buying a Samsung QLED was something that I was pretty confident in it lasting for years to come. Now, let me talk about some of the specifics of actually using this thing for a little while. This has what's called Bixby built into it, okay? And if anybody has a Samsung device, they're pretty familiar with what Bixby is. But if you're not, Bixby is kind of like Samsung's Siri, like Apple Siri, or it's kind of like their Amazon Alexa, okay? It has Bixby built in it. So you can talk to this TV and turn it on with the Bixby command. You just say, hey, Bixby. But let me tell you, it's not that good yet, okay? Samsung has some work to do with that. I would have to say that Amazon's Alexa is the leader in the industry when it comes to artificial intelligence and talking with voice commands. Siri works pretty good on my phone. Maybe not as good as Alexa, but these guys are last in line. I don't know, for some reason it doesn't understand my voice very well. I sometimes gotta yell it. It does have that capability to have that voice command in your TV. So talk about living in the future. We're like in the Jetsons age, or Back to the Future too, if you're a fan of those movies like I am. So a little bit more on that Bixby. Another reason why I'm just, don't know that I'm quite a fan of that feature on this TV is there's been times that we've been in our room watching TV and we would have a conversation with one another and then it'll pop up. Like we activated it and it did that and out of the middle of nowhere. I mean, we didn't say the word Bixby. So that feature, I'm not a big fan of it and I'm still trying to learn how to even turn off that feature that way. It doesn't interrupt our TV watching with a random pop-up. That's one of the cons on this TV that I've experienced so far. Now, the other thing that I experienced that was kind of a con is that there was a time that I turned off the TV completely and I was in the kitchen area and I was kind of cleaning and then all of a sudden the TV just came back on. How creepy is that? But I'm sure it was because of that Bixby built in there that it turned it on. So it's almost like having poltergeist TV inside your house. So that was kind of weird. It's only done that twice to me. In the middle of the night, the TV came on one time. So in the good length of time that we've owned this TV, that's happened. So that's the con on it. But the pros outweigh the cons on this TV. It is such a great TV. The clarity, the picture on it is just amazing. So let's take a look at it a little bit. So the remote on this thing looks like this, okay? So it's a pretty narrow remote. There's not a whole lot of buttons on there, so it's not real daunting. Sometimes you can get a remote that's got so many different buttons on there that you don't really know what to do with, but this is what the remote looks like, and it's kind of shaped like that. So it's almost a little bit narrow to lose into your couch or your recliner, but just keep an eye on this bad boy. Now, the great thing with this, it is a smart TV, so it does have its own smart capabilities that are built right into the TV. You don't have to go out and buy an external stick to put in there, another like a Roku device or a Fire Stick or anything like that. Samsung has that, their own smart technology built into the TV. So when you hit the home button, just like this, it brings up all the different options of apps that you can download on there. And with this being one of the newest TVs out in the market, one of the best TVs out in the market, it's got every app that you can pretty much think of. So it's got even Apple TV, which sometimes it's not available on all TVs, but this has Apple TV. It's got your Disney Plus, your Hulu, your Netflix, which are built in. And then also on the remote, it's actually got Netflix right here. It's got Prime Video and Hulu as quick shortcuts that you can press and it'll automatically launch those apps. And another thing that this TV has that a lot of TVs don't have is a Spectrum TV app. So maybe if you have cable TV, cable internet like that, the Spectrum TV app is available on the Samsung device because they only released their app to be available at the time of this recording to two different platforms, and that was Samsung and Roku. So if you have a Roku TV, Roku stick, you can get the Spectrum TV app. And if you have a Samsung, you can get that also. Like I said, it's got pretty much everything available out there on the App Store. You can get it on this TV. And along with having all the different apps that you can download, it does have its own like TV platform. So we'll go right here, this little icon. So right there's Disney Plus, Spectrum. That little icon there is kind of like their own built-in platform, and it's got free movies on there also. It's got movies that you can buy. I haven't used it too much because I've always just used our Netflix or our Disney Plus, but it does have that capability in case you buy it and you don't have a subscription to Netflix, Hulu, or any of the other ones. You can watch free movies on their built-in platform. And like I mentioned previously in the video, it's got its ambient mode, so it's got all these different options to select different screensavers on there. So we'll go to the ambient mode screen on this right now. Okay, so it's loading, and then on here on the bottom, it's got different kinds of features. It's got like My Album, so maybe if you wanted to upload your own pictures to the Samsung platform, you could have your own pictures displayed on here. It's got like artwork, it's got like different kinds of contemporary type of artwork. So it's got so many different features on there, but I kind of like the landscape view, so I've kept that on there for a little while. Every once in a while, I'll change it up. And if you are in the whole SmartThings platform with the Samsung, it is built right into this TV to where you can control some of your other devices that are in that SmartThings hub. So that's kind of a neat little feature that you're able to access it right here on your remote through there. So another way is you could always just dive into your phone, download the SmartThings app and do it that way also. So it gives you so many different ways of being able to access your content, and they do it very easily. All right, so for example, right here, this is Endgame. I wish you guys could really see the clarity of this screen here. It's kind of hard to tell from recording on it like this, but it's got excellent quality. And the sound is pretty good for just being the built-in speakers on a TV. I know a lot of people will get sound bars to put at the bottom of their TV or mount them. It has pretty good sound for just being the standalone speakers that are built in. And if you're concerned about the HDMI inputs on this, because some TVs can be limited on how many HDMI inputs they have in there, this one has a total of 4 that you can put in. I know a lot of times the way devices are going nowadays, you really don't need to be plugging stuff in because everything's going digital and downloading an app and stuff. For example, like that Spectrum TV, you don't even need boxes anymore to access your cable TV. Download an app. So we're heading in that type of generation, that type of future technology, to where, you know, not really needing to plug HDMI inputs in there as much as you did 5 years ago. But this one does have 4 available in case you need to plug a Blu-ray player in, if anybody still watches discs. Another great feature with this TV is the bezel that goes all the way around the TV right here. It's really thin, so most of what you see is just screen. There's not a whole lot of plastic that you see along the edges. Now, this is a 65-inch TV. That's what's advertised at, but I want to put a tape measure on it so that way you guys can see exactly what the exact measurement is of screen real estate that you get. So whenever they say the inches of a TV, you always measure from angle to angle like that. You don't measure across or down. So we're gonna put a tape measure on this and see what it measures out to be. All right, so got a tape measure here. Let's measure it. Okay, so the actual measurement comes to be about 65 3/8. So that's they actually give you 3/8 of an inch extra. So that's pretty good. That's what that measures, the actual measurement of screen real estate on this TV. Now I'll go ahead and measure the rest of the dimensions, the width and the height on it. That way you can see if it's possibly a TV that'll fit in your particular space. So I know whenever I go buy a TV, I'm that weirdo who does take my tape measure and measure the TV because I want to make sure it fits in my space here. I want to make sure it's not, you know, oversized or anything like that. So I'll go ahead and measure that, give you those measurements to see if it's something that you could use. All right, so the height is 32.5 overall. And then now the width. The width is 57.25, 57.25 wide. So those are the measurements on this TV. That's the footprint that it would take if you were to mount it on your wall or if you put it on a TV stand like I'm doing. So normally I do like to mount my televisions on the wall, but if you could tell, I'm on a corner here of a room, so I'm gonna have to keep it on a TV stand. Now, so that's some of the specifics of being an honest user. Probably a lot of people who are gonna watch this video are not really ones that need to dive so much into the technical part of the television. They just wanna know some of the you know, main user specifics. So that's what I've experienced so far. All
right, well, thanks for watching this video, guys, on the review for both the soundbar and the TV. Hopefully it was helpful to you if you were deciding on buying one of these items or if you're looking to buy both of them. I'll have links in the description down below where you can get these. But if this was helpful, go ahead and throw a thumbs up on this video. Go ahead and subscribe to my channel. I make tech videos all the time, and I'd love to have you back on the next one. So until then, be creative.